Turn on the ground power.
Copy. Ground power is now on.
Chief, turn off the ground power.
Copy. Ground power is now off.
Wheelchucks.
Copy. Wheelchucks are now removed.
Two is ready to taxi. Anthony Grant, Chevy Flight, we are ready to taxi.
Chevy Bassiani, Taxi Golf Alpha, runway 32.
Anthony Grant, Chevy 11, we are clear to taxi, Golf Alpha, all short runway 32. 380 knots. The tanker, let's go for the functionality of the HSI. HSI is your main navigational instrument. It is linked to other devices such as Taken, V1, radar. The knob on the bottom right will allow you to select which navigation input you want to display. The HSI mode from the left to the right and will describe which function both needles and the DME display have. The first mode is marked CV nav. It sets the compass rose to show the true heading. The second mode on the right, CZ Evil Twin, is called CM nav. It is the magnetic heading. Here in Georgia, the difference is about 6.5 degrees. You have to remember that if one of the modes is selected, it will affect all of the other systems. So if you select CM for magnetic heading, you also see magnetic heading on your head, on your radar, etc. Also remember that all the modes except CV nav and theta will use magnetic heading as a reference. The white needle you see in both modes will show you the bearing to your selected weapon, and the DME will give you the distance. The helm on contact will point you toward the signal of the station set in the second panel. If no signal is selected, or if you are out of range, the needle will be stored with the red flag on the needle. The fourth mode is marked as VAD. It is used to set up an offset point from the Taken station. And you do that with the help of the next two positions of nearly HSI, marked with the Greek letter Rho, which looks like our P, and Theta, which is similar to our zero. This mode is useful, for instance, determining a rendezvous point for a flight, or in order to set up a good initial point for approach before landing. In order to describe mode, you will follow the indication of the VIC arrow, while the thin one will always point toward the VOR station. Sure you know, but VOR stands for VHF, Omnidirectional Radio Range. So in other words, the VIC needle will be the equivalent of your CDI, when the fin needle will work exactly like on the RMI. On the left of the Taken, you will find the VOR and the ILS controls. The final mode, which I really like, is Martel, TEL, and it requires a radar lock to be activated. When you have a radar locked on something, the double arrow will show you the bearing to the current target, while the fin arrow will give you the intersection course based on the target speed and aspect. The DME will display the distance. Go ahead and check the function of the different modes as we're going to all waypoint 3. In the meantime, I have to contact Darko. Command you push, channel 4 on the green radio. Marco, this is Chevy 1, we have flight of 2 Titan Mirage 2000C. We are route to your location with the intent to refuel, currently 10 miles out.
Chevy 01, Arco, we are on station at Fred coordinates. Call back when you have us in sight.
Arco, Chevy 11, we'll go. Do you have any pilot flying takers? You know, the French Air Force is so small that we don't have a lot of women jet pilots. But when I went to Red Flag in 95, I was really glad to see that they're a very common sight into all three branches.
Roger that. Yeah, I really enjoy a female voice in stressful conditions. It calms me down.
Yeah, we had one famous woman aviator into the squadron. Her name was Caroline Aigle. She was the first woman fighter pilot into the Army Medal Air, and we were fortunate enough to have her serve with us in 2000. Fortunately, she died a year ago. She was to become the next astronaut for the European Space Agency.
Was it an accident?
Nah, cancer. Now we don't have any women flying with us. What about wars serving with the AWACS?
Go, Chevy 11, we have you inside. We request rejoin.
Chevy 11, Arco, pushing from current position, proceed to pre-contact at 20,000.
Arco 11, Chevy 21, request rejoin.
Chevy 21, Arco 11, proceed to pre-contact at 20,000, at 210.
Chevy, pre-contact.
Return pre-contact.
After communicating your intent to rejoin, you need to fail your fuel light switch. The switch is located on the left wall, right below the cross parachute lever. It has three positions. Down is going to be off, middle is going to be for the refueling where you will open the valve, and then up is for night refueling when you will also turn the lights on. When ready, you first stabilize behind a tanker and you adjust your speed and your heading. Then you slowly close in and you announce when you're ready for pre-contact. When you're working your way to the basket,
ready, pre-contact.
Not focus on the basket.
Clear contact.
Hose, focus on the tanker. Then with your peripheral vision, you kind of adjust your visual cruise to make contact. Be smooth, make only minor correction with the sticks, and work mainly with your throttle.
Two copies. Hey, how long can it take to refuel the jet?
Well, up to 10 minutes into the Fox 1 configuration. With the Mirage 2000C, you get on the station, you're out of 30-40 minutes, then you have to go hit the tanker, and you can come back for another cap, 30 minutes, then you return to base.
Contact. You're taking fuel. Transfer complete. Disconnect.
bad weather to practice an ILS approach and landing. The Mirage 2000 is equipped with a very neat feature called the synthetic runway. And I think you don't advise on your American jets.
Negative, at least not in F-15s or A-10s.
Alright, well, the first thing we have to do is to set up the TACAN and the ILS. Go ahead and set up channel 22 X-ray and 108.75, respectively. Then push in channel 1 on your green radio and contact Vyazany Tower to obtain your approach clearance. Let me know when you're ready for the next step.
Chevy 2-1, request navigation assistance. 1, inbound. request landing.
Chevy 1-2, taxi to parking spot 1-3.